Hi there and welcome to my channel. Today's project is for the Altenew Build a Flower Fuchsia Release Block Hop and Giveaway. And this month's Build a Flower stamp set is beautiful, especially because it holds a dear part of my heart. I grew up in Ecuador and we had tons of this in our backyard. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a project that is going to focus a lot on the background. And you're going to see that the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a mask with the stamp set. Because I want to create little branches coming into the pages. I'm going to use my Life Crafted album, this one, Citrus Twist Kits, to create this layout. So you're going to see that I don't have masking tape, masking paper, sorry, at this moment. So I'm going to use a post-it note, but I'm going to stamp it on them and I'm going to cut it twice. So if you don't see it right now, is I'm stamping it on two pieces of post-it and I'm just going to fussy cut around the area. I don't want to use the die even though I have it because I want to make sure that I stay the closest that I can to the stamping line. I don't want to have that white space in between. So once I have that in place, I'm going to start stamping. And like I said, my idea is I'm going to have two branches coming into the page. And for this, I am using actually watercolor paper because I'm actually going to detail this really well. So one of the things I'm going to use is black obsidian ink. This is from Altenew because this ink is crisp, really dark, and it actually really works really well with watercolor because it doesn't bleed. So you're gonna see that once I stamp the bigger flower, I'm gonna bring in those little masking pieces that I created just to cover the page so I'm able to add another stamp or another flower on top of it so it looks like it's coming from behind or behind the branch or around it. So once I've already created my little I'm gonna say vignette in this case, or these branches using the bigger flowers, you're gonna see how fast this comes together, like just the stamping. And you're gonna see that even though the set has a little branch, I am not using that branch. I'm actually gonna kind of randomly add this the flowers. I have this idea on my mind, so I know pretty much what it looks like. Like I said, we had them back home, so I know what one of those branches looks like. So once I've already stamped all the flowers, I'm gonna come in with the buds. Same thing, I'm just gonna add a few of them. I'm gonna make sure that I mask all the flowers that I already stamped so that I can add the buds as coming behind the flowers. And you're gonna see that I'm gonna combine them in some areas so that it looks like they're bunched together. And that's pretty much it. Now, if you saw me at the beginning before I started stamping, I kind of drew with my finger what it's going to look like. So I'm just going to go in right now with a pencil so I know exactly where the branch is going to go so that I can add the little, these flowers kind of hang from the branch. So there's a little piece, like I'm going to say it looks like a tiny little stem. So I'm going to make sure that I draw the line, I'm going to pencil it, what the branch is going to look like. So I can mask every single one of the flowers and add the little stems that come in the stamp set. So you're going to see that I am carefully masking right now all the buds that I stamped. And then I'm going to come in with the tiny little, it's really a really fine line that is just going to help me with some of the stems. And like I said, that's why I drew the line. So I have an idea more or less how the branch is going to look when I draw it on the paper. And you're going to see that it took no time to stamp. Honestly, this took no time to put together up to now. It came when it came to detailing. That's what it took quite a bit of time. So like I said, because I have drawn the line too, I'm gonna add a few leaves. And one of the things about this plant is that it doesn't have that many leaves when it has the flowers. It has very sparse leaves. So I'm gonna kind of, like I said, I remember this flower really well from my childhood. My mother loved them. And actually my mother used to make them out of cold ceramic. So that's how I have them really integrated on my brain. So once I have everything stamped, I'm just gonna go ahead and peel all the masking tape. And I'm not so sure if I draw the line first or start detailing. I'm pretty sure that I draw the line so I know exactly what I'm gonna do. And to draw the line, I'm gonna use actually a Sharpie. Just cause it's waterproof, is really as crisp as what I stamped. And like I said, I'm just gonna freehand it. Even though, like I said, the stamp set comes with a branch, because I did not follow the design, I just created my own, I'm gonna have to draw the line. And I don't mind it, just simple line. Like I said, I'm just gonna draw the tips of the branch coming into the page. Once I have that in place, I'm gonna start detailing. This one took a long time. I'm gonna show you a little snippets of what I created, and then I'm gonna do a lot of the work outside of the camera. There was almost 2 hours of footage just of me coloring the flowers. So you're gonna see, I'm gonna bring I'm using watercolor, so I'm gonna bring the watercolor pan set. I love it. And typically these flowers have, the center of the flowers are this really fuchsia purple tone, and the outside is a reddish coral tone. So I'm gonna follow the same colors that, like I said, this is a flower that I have very vividly in my brain. So I'm gonna follow the same colors to create or to detail my flowers. And I'm using the a simple technique, the one that I use to color my flowers, and is I'm gonna apply a wash of the color, which means I'm just gonna add the color base to each one of the petals really lightly. So if I'm gonna use purple, I'm gonna dilute it really well, so it just faintly shows all over the flower, all over the petal, sorry. And then I'm gonna come in with more saturated pigment and just go from the, I'm gonna say where the petals meet or at the center of the flower out, because that's where the deepest coloration or saturation of the color is gonna be at, especially because you have the shadows and usually flowers get darker there. I'm not gonna say all the flowers, but most of them usually start from dark to light. And in this flower, that's the case because they have like an encasing. So it's really dark at the center of it. So you're gonna see that I'm going with the fuchsia. I'm picking up some of the pigment from the pan set just because I want that richness of color, that saturation. And I'm just going to the center of the petal where it meets that little encasing and kind of dragging the paint down, and also wherever the petals meet, just to create a shadow that's gonna help me add some dimension mentioned to these 2D flowers. I just want to make them a little bit more real. And then I'm gonna continue working the same for all the flowers. Like I said, took me a while. So once I had that in place, I'm gonna come in with the reddish, I'm gonna say it's like a really reddish coral tone, and that's for the encasing of the flowers. And for that, again, I am following the same method. I am gonna create a watercolor wash from the color that I'm gonna use, and that's like I'm using that coralish kind of orangey tone, and I'm just gonna cover all the, I'm gonna say the encasing, I don't know how you would call it, sorry in English. And once I have that in place, I'm gonna come in with more of a pigmented watercolor, just to detail the areas. These ones especially, I want to give some of the detail because it is, think of a cocoon. So I'm going to make sure that some of the areas are darker just to give the shape of the roundness of the flower. Once I have that in place, I'm going to go ahead and bring more pigment and just add deeper shadows in the areas where I want to accent and I create that dimension. In this case, like I said, I want to create the roundness of the flower. And it's going to take me a while. Honestly, this took me, I had 2 hours of footage and I think an hour and a half were just of me coloring the flowers and the background, because I'm actually going to color the background once I get all this done. And then I'm going to continue. I'm going to come in to do the leaves. I'm going to use some of the green tones that I have on the pan set. I'm going to go with a really light tone because I don't want it to clash with the flowers. And then I'm going to just add the darker pigment just to the center where I have the veins of the leaves. And after that, you're going to see how I'm going to freehand my little branch that I drew. I'm just gonna go with the fine tip, and I'm using the Altenew actually watercolor brush. I really actually enjoy it because it has a fine tip, so I'm able to actually draw the line or color the line that I drew for the branch, and then actually come in and kind of add some detailing by adding a darker shade of green around it, so it gives you a little bit of dimension, brings some of the roundness of the stem. And I'm gonna set it aside to dry for a little bit. Even though I'm using watercolor paper, I want to make sure that it's completely dry before I go into detailing. Also, pistils of the flowers. So I'm going to bring a little bit of yellow to them. I'm going to use the tip of the brush and I'm going to set aside to dry for a little bit. And then I'm going to actually, I thought about leaving it white, but I wanted something that was going to bring the colors forward. So I'm going to add a wash of turquoise and blue to the background of this entire page. And for that, you're going to see that I diluted some of the watercolor on my little palette. And then I'm going to use my flat brush. I'm using a flat watercolor brush just to add the entire color to the background, being careful not to touch touch the flowers. And then I am going to bring a finer brush just to go around the area where the flowers are. I don't want to cover the flowers with the blue. So I'm going to make sure that when I go through the flowers, I bring a finer brush so that I can get in between the crevices. And I think this is one of the reasons why it took me so long to detail this. But I love how this turned out. Once I have that in place, I'm going to make sure that it dries completely. You're going to see that before I finish, I add a few splatters, especially underneath the pistils, so it looks like pollen is falling out of them. But when this is completely done, I'm going to set it aside, dry it completely before I continue working. While that was drying, I worked on the pictures. I had an idea of what I wanted to document. My brother-in-law got married July 20th. So I have quite a few pictures from there. So I picked a few of actually, I think is my husband and my two kids together. And also the other side is my brother-in-law with my kids and my niece and nephew. So we have a lot of family pictures in that case. But I did not want to cover the work that I did. So my choice was to create an insert that's going to go in between the pages that I created. So I'm going to take the stamp set, the sentiments that come in the stamp set, to add my titles, to add some sentiments around the page. And I decided to add the title to the left-hand side of my layout and add my lines of journal on the right-hand side. Like I said, I added a few enamel dots just to bring the colors that I have together. And I created an insert. These are 4x4 pictures. And I cut one of my page protectors just so that I can fit the pictures in between. And I'm just adding a few sentiments. These are from actually Pink Paisley's Indigo and Ivy collection. And I just love the fact that they are transparent, so they're not gonna take away from the background at all. I want the background and all the flowers that I created to actually be the center of this layer. And that's about it. I love how this turned out. Even though it took me a while, I just brought memories of my childhood and I loved it. And I hope you try it. Make sure you check the stamp set. The stamp set is gorgeous. Make sure if you can subscribe to the monthly program for the Build the Flowers is a great idea, because you actually get a discount on the flowers that you keep receiving monthly. And as always, if you have any questions on how this came together, please don't hesitate to contact me. I would love to give you a hand. Remember to hop onto my blog so you have a chance to win a gift certificate to the store. And don't forget to check the stamp set. It is amazing. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope to see you actually in a few days. Take care, guys.